Welcome everyone. So today we're going to have a look at another mission again in the Naval Academy of Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts. So I hope that you will like the previous episodes. So what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to switch off the music. It's sad but true, but there are some copyright issues with that music, so therefore I have to remove it. But anyway, so now what we're going to do is we're going to continue with this next mission. It's Battleship versus Torpedo Boats. So the objective is to destroy 3 torpedo boats. Test the best technology to fight against torpedo boats. You must destroy the torpedo boats attacking your battleship within the time limit. So we can design a battleship of, let's say, $7.5 million dollars, and the enemy fleet will consist of 3 torpedo boats. So from what I've already, let's say, expect from this, is that it will be best to indeed optimize the secondary, well, let's say, what are the options? We can optimize the secondary guns, maximize the effectiveness of the secondary guns. We get plus 10 tech there, and maximize some of the big guns, optimize maneuverability, which actually might also be interesting, unlock 17 components, okay, and mixed technologies. Difficult. I think we'll go for the maneuverability to dodge the torpedoes. So what we're now going to do and give a try, of course, is I think we have to optimize especially our secondary guns. And the secondary guns that we will design, or let's say fit on the battleship, that's going to be the most important part. So the displacement is fine, the speed, I think 20, let's say if we have 21 knots, it's okay. Range against are very short, of course this is not, oh yeah, we should really keep standard bulkheads. And what's important is as well, we cannot reinforce them, that's a sad. That's sad. Okay. Does this help against torpedo attacks? If we go for underwater protected deck. Perhaps, I guess a bit. So let's put that in. The armor, we go for the lighter compound armor. Right, this is lighter, right? Or not? Oh no, iron plate is lighter. Oh yeah, yeah, no, this is lighter because you do lose the plus 65% hull weight. Auxiliary engines. Okay, what's that? An auxiliary marine engine uses petrol as fuel, helps to keep the ship operational when the main engine is down. Additionally, this system provides extra power to the turret rotation mechanism. Okay. Yeah, so I think this might be interesting to put in one at least. What's this? The propeller shaft. A more durable propeller shaft with better shape design, better fits the propulsion system, so you get a bit more acceleration and turning rates, and that's improved again if we further increase that. I think shaft 1. We go with semi-oil. What's full oil? 100% engine cost. No, we're not going to do that. And then for this, I guess we have to see what we need. And here, oh, we can even go all the way up. Okay. So we don't want to spend too much because we are now spending more money than, I think, yeah, we are spending more money than weight. So This might be a bit better. If we go for diesel, should also work. I think we can go for the diesel ones. Okay. Now the bulkheads indeed, sadly, we cannot change. We just use standard ammo. That's fine. Torpedo tubes. Well, we will not put those on anyway. Okay, so here we cannot change. This is only black powder. This we can also not change. We can have an enhanced reload. I think we should put that on if feasible. And yeah, that's it, I would say. So now we start fitting some guns. Centerline guns. Oh, these look fancy. So we can go for, what's the difference? High rate of fire with this one. Oh yeah, that's a 10 incher. Yeah. Now I get it. I mean, for this mission, course, we don't need those big guns. In theory, if we have the 10 inches, that would already be fine for this. Looks great, actually. Now, secondary guns. We need a lot of these smaller ones. For that, can we fit them somewhere? Can fit them there, but that's something I don't want to. Oh, we can fit one here. I guess we can fit also one here then. Fit more here. Can we actually? Yeah, I think this will work. That looks fancy. Now, casemate guns. How much weight? Okay, we can still deal with some weight. We can put in some 6-inch guns over here, and then we go with more 4-inch guns in the top. And can we even fit something here? Oh yeah, we can. That's great. 3-inch? Yeah. Can we fit something here? No, eh? I don't know. Oh yeah, we can. 4-inch? Ooh, we're at 100% right now, and we still have to add the funnel. Ooh, that's that's going to be a problem. But perhaps we can deal with that. What we should just do, weight is okay, so we have to save some funds somewhere. Make something a bit cheaper. No, this don't help. This would help. No auxiliary engine. Perhaps we should just do that, I guess. Or will this also impact? Yeah, it will also impact cost. Okay, maybe we can do something here then, instead. We don't need that much deck armor anyway, because this is going to be a ship that just fights these torpedo boats. I do want the turrets always, it's just a habit to be a bit better protected. I just don't want the turrets to get knocked out. That's the idea. And then secondaries we can up a bit, and the conning tower we can up. ...14-inch. Can we now still put in this? Yeah, we can. I think this is fine. Like this. Yeah. Okay, let's launch. I think we should not have any issue. Oh, we hope. Depends on how quick these are. Okay, here we are. So the best thing that we can do is stay... Perhaps we should actually start to move in. Go a bit slower. We should keep our distance. Okay. Slow down a bit. Most important thing that we can do, we should do, is keep our distance. Let the secondaries look at that. Let the secondaries deal with them. Here we go. We are getting hit by one torpedo. Torpedo in the water. Should stay and look and see whether or not we should keep our eyes open for especially torpedoes. Loading. I hear torpedoes in the water. Yeah. We have to now start. Maximum speed. Hear torpedoes. Yeah, they're in the water. Slow down again. Let's see. They're not sinking as rapidly, I must say. They're pretty damaged, but they're just not sinking. I mean, they're still doing okay, structure-wise. Oh no! Well, if we're lucky, those torpedoes shouldn't be able to hit us, because that would be a bit unfair if they fight so close by. They should not be able to be primed. It seems to be that that's happening. Don't see any damage. Wow. Wow. That one is gone now. Let's see, this one doesn't have any more torpedoes. Do they even have torpedoes still? This one has one. Okay, let's see. Can we finish this one off, please? Yeah, 6 inches are opening fire now. Okay, I don't know whether we can manage in 6 more minutes. I think time might be our biggest enemy right now. I think we are running out of time. I think we failed this one again. Yeah, we failed. Yeah, we failed. Just stupid. I mean, come on. I guess I have to be a bit more aggressive then. Torpedoes in the water. Maybe we survive. At least for now. It's just that they are very difficult to hit properly. Oh, torpedoes in the water. I think we have to eat this one. Yeah. Luckily, it's not the worst that could have happened. But we have to keep an eye on those torpedoes. That's important. And I think what's also important is that we finish off certain ships before we continue to the next. The problem is that the big guns are not really hitting. And I don't know how we can improve that, to be honest. Yeah, by sailing straight, but that's of course something you don't want, considering the risks. Torpedoes coming, but we will avoid them. On. Thought I heard an R torpedo. Oh yeah. Oh, oh, oh. There's one coming. Oh! Well, luckily it's only in the stern. Come on, shoot that. It doesn't have any more torpedoes, this one, so that's good. They are out of torpedoes. Oh, but we still have only 12 minutes. Why are we just not hitting them? Okay. That was the first. I'm afraid we're still again losing just because of the time. I mean, we have 4 minutes left, but... I mean, this one is sinking, at least, but yeah, we only have 2.5 minutes left again. Problem is we just don't hit them. And I don't see how we can improve that, to be honest. Failed again. Yeah. Yeah. And then we have one left. I don't know. You would expect that this should be sufficient. We even have enhanced reloading. I mean, I don't know what we can do in order to improve it. We cannot have rangefinders. Perhaps we should replace these. Okay. Let's give this another try. Oh yeah, we're going to eat one torpedo. Okay, we've sunk the first, that's better. Already. Yeah, I saw that one coming, but luckily it seems that we were not that terribly hit. We do have to slow down. Oh yeah. Full stop. Okay, this one should now be dead in the water. You can see that the main guns really do a lot more damage. By the way. Okay, we have one remaining. It still has a torp, actually. Two more minutes. Okay, I think that's it. We failed with this mission. Don't feel really feel like repeating that one again. It's just that the gunnery is way too awful, and I don't know how we can improve that. Perhaps we should have gone for this one, maximized effectiveness of the secondary guns, instead of maneuverability, but okay. Well, I still hope that you enjoyed this episode. Next time I will try to do better. Then we go to the undefended convoy attack. And then at some point later on, I think we will repeat this scenario. And with that, I hope to see you again next episode. And let me hear what you think about the upcoming mission. Okay, see you again next time.